بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our case today is very interesting and related to the surgical cases and the surgical procedures. First of all, you have to know what is broviac catheter. This is broviac catheter. This is catheter is type of IV catheter. It's actually surgically inserted into the blood vessel in the chest that goes to the heart. Looks like central venous catheter. Central venous. So we'll go for our scenario here. This baby is 24 weeks infant, require ventilation from birth, and is now 4 weeks old. He is known case of duodenal atresia, but the surgeon don't want to operate until he is a lot bigger. He has been to theater for surgical procedure. Chest x-ray is taken to check that the procedures has been performed correctly. The appearance of the right lung is as it has been since birth. So simply, we'll take one by one. This baby, 24 weeks, now he's 4 weeks old, almost corrected age 34 weeks. Now he's almost 1 month old. He is known case of duodenal atresia. And the surgeon refused to do the surgery. Why he refused to do the surgery? Because the baby is small. He said we'll wait until he reached 3 to 5 kilos so he can fit for surgery. But he did something else rather than the duodenal atresial operation. He actually shifted the baby to theater for surgical procedures. What is this surgical procedures? This is the questions. And chest x-ray is taken to check that procedures has been performed correctly. And the second issue is the appearance of the right lung is as has been since birth. So this patient, the surgeon did for him surgical procedure. We know to know, we would like to know what is this surgical procedure. The second issue is regarding to the lung. The right lung, no aeration and opacification all over the lung. What is the reason of this lung actually since birth is no aeration at all? No aeration at all. So the questions here, if you see the questions, there is 3 questions down here. You see there is 3 questions. The first question, what does x-ray show? You have to comment about this x-ray. The second issue is, what was the surgical procedure? Is surgical procedure done for this baby? And lastly, what is the explanations or explanation for the appearance of the right lung? You see, white out, right hemisorax or right lung. White out actually is no aeration at all. So we'll take one by one. What does the x-ray show? So what does x-ray show? We'll comment about the lines. You have greens. You see, this is 3 green. This means 3 lines I have to comment about. The first line, this is ATT. I have to comment about the ATT. The ATT in the cyto or in the proper position. So the ATT, no problem with the ATT. But what about the NGT? It will goes from up to down here. If you see here, this is the NGT. If you see here, this is NGT actually in the proper position also. It goes to the stomach. Another line here, this is the procedures done for this baby. You see, this is another line here. If you see here, this is another line here. If you goes here, this is the line here. This is central venous line. This is central venous line. You see, it goes up. Up, then it goes down, it goes to superior vena cava until reach to right atrium. So this line is in proper position or no? Because this is the procedure done for the baby, the insertion of central line. This line, how to know it's in correct position and not mal position? This line actually goes to superior vena cava. So the proper position of central venous catheter, it will be in the tip of the heart. In the tip of the heart, you see, in the tip of the heart, it's not goes to the heart. So it will be in the junction between the superior vena cava or the junction of superior vena cava and right atrium, or on the tip of the heart, on the tip of the heart. Why we need to be cautious about that? Because if this line goes to the heart, or the central line is goes to the heart, what is the complication with having for this baby? Three complication: A, P, C. A, arrhythmia. Any lines goes to the heart lead to arrhythmia. P, it will be pericardial tamponade. Pericardial effusion, pneumopericardium. This is the B, 3B, 3B, pericardial tamponade, pericardial effusion, pneumopericardium. And the C, the last C, cardiac arrest or cardiac failure. Cardiac arrest or cardiac failure. So if the line, the proper position of the central venous line, it's come from up, it will be in the tip of the heart. It's not goes to the heart, in the tip of the heart. The proper, it will be between the junction of the superior vena cava and right atrium. Like the umbilical venous catheter. What is the proper position? It will be actually between the junction of the inferior vena cava and right atrium. It will be in the junction between inferior vena cava and right atrium. It's the line is come from up like this case. This line is coming from up here, from superior vena cava. It should be in the tip of the heart. It not goes to the heart. It will be between the junction of the superior vena cava and the heart. Because if goes to the heart, A, B, C, arrhythmia, pericardial tamponade, pericardial effusions, pneumopericardium, and cardiac arrest, cardiac failure. So this is we comment about the X-ray and line. What goes for the lung? You see the here, the right lung. The right lung, you see, this is white out. White out, no aeration. Opacification, you know, opacification, this means white. White lung. Or decreased aeration, no aeration. This either collapse or consolidation collapse or lung hypoplasia or aplasia. How to differentiate between the three entities? Since this actually, this lung since birth, the baby now is 1 month, and this lung since birth, so it's against collapse and consolidation. But how to differentiate between collapse and consolidation? Collapse, actually, if there is collapse in the right lung, If you did for the patient CBT, suction, and the right side position up, and all of this, it will be, there is some aeration will be appear. Some aeration it will be, or the lung will improve immediately. If you just, maybe there is mucus plug or something like that, you do suction, CBT, or physiotherapy, and the right side up, the lung, it will be inflated immediately. But this patient actually, since 1 month or since birth, the lung is same. So it's against the collapse. But might be consolidation or pneumonia. If there is pneumonia actually, same actually, it will be same pneumonia. It will be some batches or diffuse pneumonia like emphysemas or something like that. It will take at least maybe 10 days after antibiotic coverage, or even 14 days, the lung will improve. But since birth, and the patient now is 1 month, and the lung same. So this is case of lung aplasia or lung hypoplasia. Based on ruled out then the collapse and consolidation or pneumonia. So this is lung hypoplasia or aplasia. How to know this is lung hypoplasia or aplasia? Three. If you look for the chest, total chest like this, it's actually narrow chest or bell-shaped chest. This is the first one. From outside to inside. Chest. It's narrow and bell-shaped chest. Then it goes for the ribs. So the chest, the rib cage, and also it goes for the ribs. Ribs, actually, it will be thin. Thin ribs. And you see here, crowded and down sloping and steeping of the ribs. Down sloping and steeping of the ribs, it will give you clue this is hypoplastic lung. If goes up or upwards, stippling lung, it will be hyperinflated lung. But down, because actually the lung is small, no lung at all. So the chest, it will be small, and the ribs, it will be thin, and it will come down because no aeration to expand the lung or to goes up, no aeration at all. So the aeration, no aeration, the high to the ribs, it will be down sloping of the ribs. It will be crowded because no aeration, no air to open this one. So it will be collapsed and crowded and it will come down. This is lung hypoplasia or aplasia. Three, the chest cage at all, it will be small and narrow. The ribs, it will be thin and down sloping, stepping. And the lung, it will be white out, or it will be a diffuse opacification or no aeration at all. So it will give you clue, this is lung hypoplasia. And even it's taking long time, the baby is 1 month old. If collapse, it will improve. If pneumonia, it will improve. This is all against collapse and consolidation. This means this is lung hypoplasia or lung aplasia. So this is what does the x-ray show. Already we said this is lines, three lines in the lung hypoplasia. What the surgical procedure done, this is central venous line insertion. You see here, this is central line venous insertion. And what is the explanation of appearance of the right lung? We said this is explanation. It might be collapse, it might be consolidation, it might be lung hypoplasia or aplasia. Actually, since birth and the patient is 1 month, this is against collapse and consolidations. This is the central venous catheter, and this is the procedures done for the baby. We call it broviac lines. And if you see here, this goes down here. This is the superior vena cava. You see, this is the superior vena cava, and the line, it goes to the tip of the heart. It's not goes to the heart, just between the junction of superior vena cava and the right atrium. Actually, it's the tip, on the tip of the heart, because if it goes to the heart, 3 ABC, arrhythmia, pericardial tamponade, pericardial effusions, pneumopericardium, and C, cardiac arrest, cardiac failure. So this is the x-ray. It shows the ATT and GT in the position, and central venous catheter, actually the tip on the thoracic inlet, and large pore central catheter actually in the right with the tip on the junction between the superior vena cava and right atrium. And the right lung actually is opaque with no aeration at all. No aeration at all. So the central venous catheter, this is the procedure done for these patients. It's large pore catheter, is broviac lines. Actually, it's called this broviac lines. And lung aplasia and hypoplasia in the right lung. In the fact, the lung has always had this appearance, and the infant is now 4 weeks old, is strongly against collapse or consolidation as cause of this appearance. And we mentioned it, how to differentiate between collapse, consolidation, lung hypoplasia. And put on your mind, lung hypoplasia from outside to inside. Rib cage, it will be small and narrow. The ribs, it will be actually thin and down sloping because no aeration at all to open this one. So it's crowded and down sloping, steeping down. And also, if you look for the lung, it will be diffuse opacification, no aeration, opaque. Opacification, this means no aeration, it will be white out, right lung actually indicate this case of hypoplasia or lung aplasia. So at the end, I would like to pray for my colleagues going for examination after a few days. Saudi board, Jordan board, and the Arab board, and Egyptian board, and my colleagues in neonatal fellowship. As Allah Rabb al-Arsh al-Azim, inna qahzum ala'na jami'an, ya Rabb, insha'Allah. Shukran, salamu alaikum.